Hi, this is Penny, and in this lesson, we will review the ray model of light. Here is what we know so far. Light is a form of radiant energy, and it moves out or radiates in all directions from a light source. Light can be emitted from a natural or artificial object, and sources of light can be classified as incandescent, which are heat-producing light sources, or luminescent, and these do not produce heat, and sometimes are referred to as cold light. There are different types of luminescent sources, such as fluorescent, phosphorescent, chemiluminescent, or bioluminescent sources. So we're off to a great start, but we still need to know more to explain some of light's properties. One important property of light is actually explained by a shadow, or an absence of light. Here we have two students walking along a path, and the sun is clearly behind them as they are casting long shadows on the path in front of them. Have you ever wondered where these shadows come from? Why doesn't the light just go around them? The fact that light is a form of energy doesn't completely explain this behavior. Instead, we need to understand how light moves from one point to another. Here's how this works. A light source emits or radiates light in all directions. A ray is any one of these straight lines that represent the path light will take. We call this the ray model of light. But how do we know that light travels in rays? The answer is actually in shadows. Okay, so we have a light source and we have an apple. Believe it or not, this is all we need to illustrate the ray model of light. The light bulb is a luminous object, and this means it emits light. The apple doesn't emit light, so it and all other unlit objects are described as non-luminous. We can only see the apple when a light source is present. With the light to the right of the apple, we would expect to see a shadow on the ground to the left. Agreed? If not, try it yourself with a light source and a similar object. Our light bulb is going to emit light in all directions, and some will be in the direction of the apple. We only need to draw a few rays here to show what happens when light strikes the apple. The rays that hit the surface of the apple allow us to see it. We therefore say the apple is illuminated. This is how we see objects that do not emit light. But we'll look at this in more detail in a later lesson. For now, notice how a few of the rays hit the surface of the apple and stop. This helps explain the presence of the shadow on the ground behind it. The apple blocks the rays, and the shadow results because the light does not bend around the apple. This is the basis for the ray model of light. Light travels in straight paths. The ray model of light also explains how the distance between an object and a light source affects the size of its shadow. If we take two apples and place them at different distances between a light and a wall, we can see the shadows are different sizes. But why does this happen? Because light spreads out from its source, the rays are more closely bunched by the light, so the apple closest to the light is able to block more rays, therefore creating a bigger shadow. Further away from the light, rays are more spread out, so the more distant apple will block less rays, causing a smaller shadow. Between this and our previous lesson, we can now say that light is a form of energy that moves in straight lines. The ray model of light can help us explain how light interacts with different types of materials. Clear materials, for example, allow rays of light to take a straight path right through the material. We call these materials transparent, which comes from Latin and means easily seen through. Transparent materials include the lenses in these eyeglasses, some plastics like this packaging used for pasta, even a regular drinking glass and the water it holds are both transparent materials. When light strikes certain materials, some light is able to pass through, but the light gets a little scattered and it's unable to stay on the original straight path. Some rays may even bounce back off the object. We call these types of materials translucent, which means to shine through. This conference room window really highlights the difference between transparent and translucent materials. As you can see in this image, the whitish, frosted glass allows some light to pass through, but we can't make out any details. This glass is therefore translucent. The unfrosted glass, however, lets light pass directly through, and we can clearly make out the objects behind the window. This material is therefore transparent. Many materials block light altogether. As light strikes the surface, it is either absorbed or reflected back. Again, we will look at this in more detail in a later lesson, but for now, just know that we call these materials opaque. And opaque means shady or dark. And this is because we can't see through these materials, and they are the ones that block light and cast shadows. There are many different types of opaque materials. Take this image, for example. We have a ceramic mug sitting on a wood desk in front of a painted wall. We can't see behind any of these objects, so they are all considered opaque. Now look at this image. How many opaque materials do you see? You can give yourself a point if you counted the mirror. It's a pretty obvious choice since we can't see through it and we can see it's casting a shadow. Is that all? No. Notice the floor and the wall. We can't see through them either, so they must also be opaque. Finally, we have a little rabbit. Is he opaque? You betcha. We can't see through him and he is casting a fantastic shadow. Have any friends or family around? Yep, they are opaque too. In fact, I bet you can spot at least 5 opaque materials around you right now. They are literally everywhere. And here is the big picture for this lesson. Luminous sources emit light, and light follows a straight path called a ray. Objects that do not emit light are called non-luminous, but can be seen when illuminated. Light can interact with materials in different ways. If light is allowed to pass straight through, we call it transparent. If some light is blocked, but some is allowed to go through, it's translucent. And if the material blocks most or all light, then it is opaque. And opaque materials are the ones that cast shadows. Thank you for watching.